Wednesday, April 18th, Town of Dyton Planning Board meeting. First item, or actually, I should remind everybody that this is a public meeting being video and audio recorded for posterity. Let's all stand to pledge allegiance, please. Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, first item on the agenda is to reorganize the board. So we are going to reorganize the deck chairs.
Nominate Peter Bedby as chairman.
I will second that motion.
No discussion?
None whatsoever.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Nominate Tom Pires as vice chair.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Nominate Bob Bona, clerk of the board.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Here you go.
Beautiful.
Okay, would anyone like to make a motion to approve the meeting minutes from April 4th?
So moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, let's see, let's review 1727 William Street. That is this plan.
Joe and I will share.
We might share as well, then.
So this is the old lot, the whole thing?
Yeah, and it goes all the way down. So what I did is I showed on insert the overall piece because it's from this corner down, it goes back 1131.71 feet back to a stone wall and it comes back up. So that's the overall. What we're proposing to do is break one house lot out of it containing 175 feet of frontage. It's a rectangle, so it's 200 by 175, so it's 35,000 square feet. It's all uplands.
You're going to subdivide that?
He may. He talked to me when Heidi was around. He talked to Heidi about doing a conservation subdivision possibly out there.
So how big is the remainder?
The remaining land is shown here. I got frontage of 175 and then some additional frontage here of 60 feet, .92. So the total area is left is 654,701 square feet.
And how many acres is that?
That's about...
40,000
divided into that, at least
15.
Yeah,
15
plus.
So they could.
I thought he was just cutting out the house.
Yeah, he's just cutting the house out for now. And then he's going to see what
they could do. A couple of retreat lots, or they could do.
Yeah, he's got a lot of options.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we did stake it out.
It's roughly about 15 and a half acres left, give or take.
Yeah, we put iron rods at all the corners to delineate. This is paper. There's a store wall that picks up further down. It goes all the way down to the wall, and it comes up by Catavius property. By a store wall that kind of fades away in this area.
You know, this was abandoned in the 70s.
Was it?
So he probably owns half of that at this point.
Yeah, I don't know what the deal is on it. We have to check legally.
Yeah, you'd have to legally see what happened with it. I know it was abandoned in the 70s, but...
Yeah, it used to be called Audrey Lane, then it went to Brook Street.
It used to be clear at one point.
Yeah.
This is office.
There's still nice walls parallel all the way down to my house. I thought it was my house. I didn't know about the other one.
Everything left, we got 15 and a half acres left.
I'm poised.
All right, motion to approve.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Plan A. Well, she'll see it, I know. AP 6, Lot 23, 1727 William Street, prepared for Tony Roderick by Proline Engineering.
Second again?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, there you go.
Thank you.
Well, I'll be easy, huh?
Oh, wait a minute.
All these have to be signed?
Yep.
Yeah, can I borrow your pen?
No, there's plenty in there. You need a black one, a black one, Joe. Yeah, I got black, man.
This is black, too.
What did I give you, a blue one?
You gave me a blue one.
Okay, here we go. Oh, go ahead, go.
You still have a pen?
Yep.
There you go.
It is 8/4/18.
Yep, 18, yep.
Oh, will you take those, Bob? We have them down there because.
I'll take care of Dayton while I get.
When I was filling in here, I noticed a lot of plans with no dates, there's two. What's today, 18?
Yep.
Yeah. I don't think I sent that one yet, did I?
Pete, wanna grab a Sharpie out of there?
Can I press red or black?
Black.
Keep a couple for us, huh?
Is there any plan for black to actually get more into the computer end of it rather than? We're always gonna be signing Mylars.
Yeah, but they're gonna be I'm talking about PDFs and stuff like that.
We hope sooner or later.
Sooner or later?
Sooner or later, yeah. Kerry does a good job, once she catches up and figures out what's going on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we can always send the PDF. And even copy that and send you a PDF.
Yeah.
Register and fix it.
Actually.
How's Tony doing?
Seemed better as of a few days ago. He said that they have hope, the doctors have hope. So, brought him some Quahogs a couple of days ago, made him happy.
I don't know why we can't use 11x17s.
Yeah, that's how they come out of the registry, after they put him in there.
Yeah.
They order them, that's how they come out.
I mean, our rules and regs say 18x24, but it's 11x17 is big enough.
Yep.
Those big plans are a pain in the neck.
But we have to go before the town meeting.
It's gonna be, it'd have to be a bylaw change, that's right. That'll be another time and place.
Yeah, we have a bigger fish to fry at the moment.
We have enough to do.
I'll just grab one, please, we'll hang on to that.
You only want one?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Bob, good seeing you, take care.
Yeah.
Good night.
Okay, next item on the agenda is to review, discuss, and act on the marijuana overlay district medical and recreational I, or one zoning bylaw and two zoning expansion. So, we have before us a draft marijuana zoning bylaw, which basically revises the medical marijuana bylaw and expands it to include recreational, and it does two things. It expands it to include recreational, and it also changes words to make it compliant and consistent with the state's marijuana regulations. Comments other than.
This is a nice clean copy. If you.
There is a clean.
Same thing.
Yep. Yeah, okay. It helps to
Did you see this picture? You want a copy? Well, yeah, you can use the one that's lined, been lined out and so forth.
So again, all, a lot of the comments and revisions are because the rules have changed and we're just trying to stay consistent with the rules.
Okay. I should have read this once, and I think you and I were down with it, had a couple of comments and.
I believe, but I'm just kinda guessing.
Same thing, yeah.
That the next step is to motion to propose or to propose these revisions and expansions of the bylaw to the town meeting, is that correct? Am I missing?
Yeah, it would just be the with this, as far as the boundaries, that's a normal.
That's the next that's next on the agenda. Or that's part two of this particular discussion.
Right.
It's like there's a.
So what you're looking for now is a motion to accept the amended zoning bylaws for our medical and recreational marijuana.
Yes.
Use in the town of Dayton.
Uh-huh, unless anyone.
As advised by our council.
Yes.
For submission to town meeting, right?
Mm-hmm.
Woody?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Or do you have any questions? It's a lot of information to absorb in this short time unless you've seen them already, but we can answer questions if you want.
I've seen them.
They're basically, we're trying to, as I said, be consistent with the state regs as well as give the town the control over what's coming down the pike recreational wise to some extent.
As far as the next one goes regarding the this 200 William Street.
Oh wait, we still haven't.
Oh, okay, we got more to do.
We haven't we also have to discuss the expanded did we vote on this last time? I don't remember.
We did.
We did vote on it, so there's really nothing to discuss.
No, but I think I would be more comfortable if we sent this to GZA and gave him our.
Oh yeah, we will. We definitely need to.
For an appropriate legal description of the property.
Yes.
Okay.
So it will be defined properly at town meeting.
Do we need to make a motion for that, or can I just send it to them?
No, I'll move to defer this for to GZA for amendment to the town zoning map to show the area of 200 William Street to Taunton City Line as the marijuana overlay district.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, I will.
So you're gonna take care of that?
I'll take care of that on tomorrow. It's just a matter of emailing them this PDF.
So as far as another area goes, 620 Spring Street is out, right?
Right. Oh, that's out now?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a call today from Elliot Oliveira, and he said that Mr. Merrigan at the mill has declined to have any marijuana use at 620 Spring Street.
Well, if we are successful with this at the town meeting, we still have Prince's House. And while Prince's House may have been reluctant to have a medical marijuana retail location, they may not be reluctant to have a
Manufacturing,
because it is kind of manufacturing location.
I thought what they said was that they wanted nothing to do with marijuana.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
I think Joe's right with that statement. I think that was the initial response.
In fact, it got so bad that they actually said, don't ever contact us again.
Really? I think we ought to remove it.
You know what? I say leave it. And let it be.
Well, yeah, because they could sell that building.
Right, I was just going to say the same thing. If that building gets sold, then there's an opportunity.
They can't be doing, I don't know how much business, how full is that place?
From my understanding, it's pretty empty, but obviously Co-op's is still there. But I heard a rumor, and I'll do it as that they were going to tear it down and rebuild it. Is there a plastics company, Interplast? Is the name of the group that runs it, but there are people that own it are out of the country, obviously.
So the plastics company is there now?
No, it's in New Jersey.
Oh.
But Interplast owns the whole complex. Now, are they waiting for the Co-op to make a move, because that's the biggest tenant they have left?
Well, there is a plastic bag company that runs.
Yeah, but their thing is to rebuild it. It's a rumor I heard. They want to tear it down, rebuild it into a manufacturing, industrial, to do what they do.
I thought the corporate headquarters was out of Boston.
They have, I think it's out of New Jersey. The corporate headquarters are in Boston.
It's out of Boston, yes.
Okay.
So I don't know. I know that we.
What's the name of the place?
We had
Interplast.
Inner.
Inner.
Inter.
Or Interplast.
I mean, this is according to Heidi when she. Whoops. Maybe that shouldn't be said.
Well, Peter Merrigan, Boston Corp. is out of Boston, but they're actually they are out of foreigners that own.
Are you saying it says Interplastic Corporation? This is Ohio? One in Michigan? It's Interplast Group Limited is Boston. Interplast. Interplastics. It's Interplastics, right? Correct? Is that what we're saying?
No, it's Interplast.
Plast.
Yeah.
Interplast.
Last corporation.
With Dighton, Mass., Covington, Kentucky, South.
This Mr. Elliott they called me today, he was only looking for 2,000 square feet.
Really?
Yeah. So.
Well,
I'll rent them my basement.
Yeah.
Well, if our overlay district is successful, there's got to be 2,000 square feet up in that area.
Yeah,
one of those buildings.
Yeah.
There's
some huge buildings back there.
Yeah, so.
I'll call him back tomorrow.
Yeah.
If you don't mind.
No, not at all.
Did you have any thoughts about locations?
Well, I talked about the one potentially down the road from Dunkin' Donuts down. And then Peter was on board with marijuana a few months ago. But obviously, he's changed his mind once more.
His tenants were very concerned that the odors emanating from this prospective plant would make their employees less productive.
but the thing is,
but they would be happy.
They'd be happy.
They need a little more education in regards.
Yeah,
be happy and hungry.
You know, how the it's not like obviously when they build out like a grow park, they're gonna have it very well insulated.
Oh, yeah.
So it's, it's.
But that's really between the landlord and the tenant, it really doesn't have anything to do with this board. If the tenants were concerned, or if the landlord is concerned with this prospective tenant, then he would just write into the lease that you can do this, but smell is if it's measurable, it's gotta be eliminated, so.
Right.
At any rate, it's really.
Well, I think he may need some more education.
Yeah.
Which I can go over and have somebody else come over and talk to him about the impact of that.
But unfortunately.
For this one, for this town, it's not gonna happen, but in the future.
It's not gonna happen. Yeah.
There's an area, the area you just mentioned, I just wanted to throw that out there also, because it was mentioned to me by one of the selectmen also. We're talking the area from Reese's Gas Station down to Taunton Line.
On the west side of the street?
West side of 138. That is a mixed use district with a business underlying zone. So it could be done. No houses there, right? Only be, houses would be behind it.
Just that trailer that they rent out.
Yeah.
Well, there's houses on the back.
You're right.
On the back.
On Somerset Avenue side.
Yeah, Old Somerset.
I mean, did we ever set a distance from residential homes?
Well, it's in a residential zone, those homes. I mean, a business zone.
Right, but did we ever set?
We have never, no. It's just a school, church, playground.
Yeah, 100 feet from residential zone, which is across the street. So if we're putting.
Automatically throws it right up.
Not really, cause if you're putting them on the west side of 138, right on the highway side, I don't think it's 100 feet to the other side, do you?
Oh, yeah. The road is only 40 feet.
Yeah, up this end, but as you, Somerset Ave curves, right?
There's a wide part.
Yeah.
Like if,
Where they were specifically talking was Charlie Harris's garage.
Right.
Yeah, that's, but that, they've been approached to see if they would sell or they would be willing to do something, and they said no.
Is it empty?
Oh, it's been empty for years.
I wouldn't sell it.
I think, I was told that he was doing some appraiser work on it with the intent to sell.
Really? That's nice to hear.
Maybe we could do a little homework, and I don't think we just wanna, I have a problem with just zoning an area without talking to people who live.
Right, if the landowner was coming to see us for that, then it's another story.
Well, that doesn't mean that, if he owns it, I mean, if we zoned it, and if he doesn't wanna do anything, he doesn't have to.
Right.
But if he sells it, the new owner would have a different, another option.
I have another thought or a question. Do we want to put another article on for 100 William Street only in case 200 William Street fails?
Why would it fail?
Any number of reasons.
Yeah, exactly.
So you want to put another?
I mean, I like the 200 Williams down to Taunton Line, but we know we have something with 100.
Well, anyone that's going to oppose the larger area is going to have the same opposition to the one lot.
Yeah, true.
So if we if we try to do both, we are looking a little underhanded. Or less than.
Unsure.
Yeah.
Not confident.
Yeah, well, no, we're looking kind of, it's almost like we're trying to do an end around to get something done, so.
But there's a lot of other businesses past that 100 to 200 that could probably do something.
Yeah, if I were a landowner in that area, I'd be excited to have the rezoning.
Me too.
Have you got any type of square footage on the grow center plus the business itself? Because they're also gonna have to have a grow center. As far as how many acres they need.
There are different rules for small grows.
They call them tiers.
Yeah, tiers, yeah.
Tiers, yeah.
Tiers, so.
I think there are 11 different tiers.
So the.
Up to 100,000 square feet.
The 100 William Street is 8 acres, and it could do a lower tier cultivation and as well as recreational. And it's, right now it's just loaded up with parked cars, so it's really not a, it's really.
Right.
If someone complains it'll increase the traffic, well, it's gonna decrease the traffic.
Is there anything in the ground that, anything that you guys know of?
No, after 30 years of cars parked there, they may have oil issues, but that's not.
Well, it's got all those tires, but.
Yeah, the tires.
That's true, yeah.
But the tires are,
They've been there for 50 years.
Retaining walls.
Yeah, they've been there for 50 years.
They're retaining walls, that's what they use them as.
They are now. Back then, I think they just disposed of them.
Well, whoever decides to put something there, they have a lot of obstacles ahead of them before they ever see any type of facility. The application packet for any of those businesses are just intense. And there's a lot to it. And if you don't have the financing, like this company who's looking at this particular 100 William Street, I don't think they get all their finances together. They have a plan, but their plan, I thought their plan was weak when it compared to Green Harbor's plan. Green Harbor had a nice solid plan. These people are just taking a shot in the dark, and they basically told me they did not have 100% of their funding yet. So they're looking for funding.
But once we have a medical overlay, what role does the town play in choosing if you have several applicants and only one?
Well, we have, the Board of Selectmen has to negotiate a deal with them.
Right. Once so they can pick.
Well, there may be a medical at 100 Williams. There may be a cultivation at 202 Williams or whatever it is down the road there, 198 Williams, where all the buildings are.
Right.
It could be, you know, depending on if the owners want to do anything.
Because there may be other options than just the one that you were talking about.
Yeah. But the reality is,
once we have it.
But once we have it, the process is they negotiate with the town to get a letter of support that
right.
they can take to the state to apply for the permits. So I read in the paper there were 200 permit applications on the first day. And most of them were medical marijuana facilities that wanted to expand. And I think 116 were deemed complete. You know, maybe 2 years from now will be 117 in the town of Dayton. It may take 2 years. But until we get the next step, this step,
right.
which is have a place that's viable as opposed to the Prince's House, which is zoning that's not viable. So
I think I told you with this, what we're proposing, the marijuana overlay district encompasses all facets of the marijuana business.
Right.
Medical, adult use, cultivation, edibles, so whatever everybody can do.
And processing.
Yeah.
Labs. They also have labs.
Yeah.
Testing
labs.
Yeah. The more important thing for us is to establish the zoning, and then they'll come looking for us.
Yeah.
Right.
Because more than half the communities in Massachusetts have either had a moratorium or voted no entirely.
Right.
So anyone seriously looking to open one of these businesses is seriously looking for a community that will accept it,
right.
and a community that has good services, such
yeah.
as, you know, electricity,
well,
water, that kind of stuff.
The town of Attleboro, the city of Attleboro is really gung-ho on it, and they're thinking that they're gonna get everybody from Rhode Island coming in.
Hmm.
So, we're not that far from Rhode Island.
Right.
So
no, we're not.
It could be.
That they have even to be residents
of Mass. No, you just have to drive across the border. Absolutely.
Okay.
There was an article in the Providence Journal bemoaning the fact that all these stoners are going to be running up north and coming back south. So it's not
far-fetched.
No,
I meant the owner. I thought you.
The way you put that.
It's cannabis tourism. They'll be coming to Dayton.
It'd be nice if we could set up some restaurants at the same time.
There you go.
I tell you, it might be interesting, but I don't think they do it there. Ralph Sylvia's kid, Gary?
Gary.
The farm.
Yeah.
I bet you he'd be interested in something, he's.
I don't think he would be.
You don't think?
Who is this?
Gary Silva. Ralph Silva's son.
On Tremont.
The farm on Tremont.
Yeah, no, that's a very, very good thought, but I'm just wondering, how well is he doing over there? With the town.
As far as.
Well, then maybe we shouldn't be discussing that.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, not that part.
No.
No.
At the.
When I left.
I think okay, though. No. Okay.
So moving on, we don't really have much new to add to C of section six, so our next is the Southeastern Regional Planning and Economic Development District Regional Commission recommendation, which is for a representative from this board. And if no one on the board is interested in becoming that liaison person, I suggest that we have Kerry do it.
They're also gonna be asking the ZBA if they have a person. And they talked about it last week on Selectmen's meeting. They're just looking for a person to go to this meeting, it's once a month. There used to be a woman from North Dayton, Mrs. Kupla, I think, and she did it for years.
Donna Kupla.
Yeah, whatever her name is, I don't know.
Yeah.
But anyway, I guess she's no longer attending these meetings.
I think Kerry would be.
So they're looking for a name. I don't think Kerry's gonna wanna do that, it's kinda like.
Oh, they.
Might surprise you.
It's at night.
Oh, it's at night.
They're night meetings, they're once a month.
Now, didn't Nancy Goulart used to attend, or did she still?
No, Mrs. Kupla, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing her name wrong, but she always did. If I wasn't on the CPC, I wouldn't mind attending, cause I know a lot of the people at Serpent. If anybody else is willing to go on the CPC. Wanna see a show of hands.
What does Serpent, what do they?
It's once a month, and I don't, it's a Wednesday also, right, so that makes it tough for us.
I have meetings every Wednesday now.
Right.
It's either planning.
Right, it's once a month, and it's on a Wednesday, and I'm not sure the time, but it's definitely on a Wednesday, and it's once a month.
It can be.
But they could get a average, they could get a citizen to do it.
Like Mr. Ryan's, right?
Well, he's on the ZBA, maybe he'll sign up.
Maybe we should table it for now and find out more information, because if it doesn't conflict with this, our meetings, and if Kerry's not interested in going, I might be interested in going.
There's a lot of good contact people there.
Well, that's, yeah.
Yeah, you might like it, Peter.
Well, I would imagine, many of my alumni from Bridgewater State University now, from the MPA program are there. I know that we talked about it a lot during.
No, there's some nice people there.
When I was going for the master's degree on. So, I don't wanna commit right now, I wanna find out more about it, like when they meet.
Right.
But if it doesn't conflict with this, I could see myself going.
There you go.
But we just voted you in for the next 5 years, right?
No, that was me, Joe.
Just for another year. And I don't know what a year from now brings in my life, but I'll be 60, so it's
Can't believe it, he looks like he's 50.
Yeah, if I have hair, I'd look even younger.
That's easy. That's easy.
I just have a question. What is that all about, though? What is, if you have a representative, what's
Regional issues, regional planning and development. I know that a lot of it is related to traffic, some of it is grants. For instance, there are many different grants the town may be eligible for that we don't know about. Well, having someone at these meetings would be a means of learning more about what grants are available. For instance, we've talked on this board for years about how it would be a good thing to have an expansion of the sewer district, both for economic development as well as to protect the Taunton River. Now, we may not be able to qualify for an economic development grant to expand our sewage system, but we may be qualified to expand the sewer system to keep the Taunton River nitrogen levels low. I'm just making this stuff up, but my point is that until we
go to
the...
Yeah, but it's factual. You know, I mean, you're not making it up.
But until we go to these meetings, we don't know what's available to us. And we did have a joint meeting a month ago with this Board of Selectmen about a piece of land that might be available to the town. And during that meeting, we talked about sewer. Well, and it seemed that the consensus was that this expanded sewer system would be good, but no one knew how to go about making it happen without killing the taxpayers or the abutters. So again, this is just an example that having somebody attend these meetings would learn about a sewer grant or sidewalks, or there's a number of things that we just don't know about because we don't have a representative there. So that would be one of the reasons. As well to find out what other towns are doing and to get their get ideas from them. So it's a both a sharing of information and a combining forces to expand the southeastern region. But again, I can't commit it this time, so I suggest someone make a motion to table it for either the next meeting or the meeting after, and then maybe we can come to a conclusion. Meanwhile, I'll find out when they meet and that sort of thing.
Yeah, I'll make that motion. table.
I second.
On favor?
Aye.
Okay, no one's opposed. Next item on the agenda is public input. Do you have any input?
What about Larry Spellman's, I'm back to the marijuana locations. Larry Spellman's property.
Where's that?
The auction.
At the auction.
Heavy equipment auction.
It's close to Alice's.
Yeah.
Well, we did try to have an overlay district across the street and it failed.
Yeah, that was above a restaurant.
Yeah.
And there was a daycare on the, there was a daycare on that.
No, no, the daycare's down
the
street.
Yeah, daycare's moved down.
Long gone. They're paying $700 a month less by being at the at the Almeida's market.
Oh, okay. Okay. I guess that's a good reason.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So if he wants to sell a piece of that to the town.
Yeah, he does. For way too much money.
Yeah, and he also wants to buy the old, what's now called Daddy-O's, and turn that into a virtual truck auction center. Really, I don't see where, at this point, really nothing to concern us with that piece of land.
Well, Sam, we're talking about that piece of land and Mr. Spellman. I don't know if you noticed the traffic at the last auction.
Heavy.
It was heavy.
Oh yeah, it was.
And the parking was absurd. There was parking.
Now, do they have a detail? He's supposed to have a detail.
Well, I didn't see any police officer out in the street at all, ever, and I went by several times.
Oh really?
Now, there may have been one on the property somewhere. But parking was out of control.
Yeah.
And if you're taking that little side street behind Giorgio's and trying to come out, it was kind of...
Old Somerset.
Yeah, Old Somerset Ave. Somerset. It was kind of hairy trying to pull in and out of there.
Old the North, I got Somerset.
Yeah. So, I don't know if does that follow under us, because it was kind of a public safety hazard, if you ask me.
I know that he went... He spoke to the Board of Selectmen who asked for a detail on those days, and I understand that he said he would provide a detail.
He's there, I've seen him, but he's not, like, as Mr. Wood said, out near the street.
Oh, so the...
And Massachusetts state law states there's no parking on a highway, even though that is a secondary highway, it's still patrolled by the state troopers.
There are cars parking on the alongside the road?
Yeah, yeah. On both sides, even on the little island where Giorgio's was.
Then the police department should be up there with their ticket books.
Yeah, right.
Have a Stadies.
They don't wanna do that because it defers from the business. If they do that, it takes away from the guy's business.
Yeah.
Tag all those guys that are going down for the auction.
But he should create a pocket spot big enough for.
Although it looks like there's more space out back than there was.
He does, he got enough land out, he doesn't use the land that he's gonna sell.
Exactly.
It was a mess, the last auction was a mess.
Well, that soccer field in front of it, I don't think he uses all the space up front for the vehicles that are going in auction. So he should be able to park vehicles out back.
That soccer field, I was out there, I went through there one day, forget it, this time of the year, it's a mud hole.
Oh, yeah.
They park on Daddy's?
Mud hole.
Yeah, they park in Daddy's.
It was trucks and all these people drive big trucks, there's no cars there, they're all big boots.
Yeah, big 350s.
Yeah. And the other thing he has out front is a lot of those banners, and I think it clearly says in the zoning bylaws that those are illegal, all those banners. And there's that big sign on the 18-wheeler. That whole area is getting pretty much congested and littered with advertising.
But he has that written on the side of a tractor trailer, so how can we control that?
Well, the sides can only be a certain size.
Yeah.
It's a side of, it's a tractor trailer with painted or whatever.
No, it's a banner, it's not painted.
Yeah. Well, but it's a banner on the side of a tractor.
I don't have the zoning bylaws with me, but it says in the zoning bylaws that none of that stuff is legal. So, whose job is it?
Zoning enforcement officer.
Zoning enforcement officer.
Yeah.
He's a busy guy.
Yes, he is.
The town goes to him for everything.
Well, it's his job.
Right.
To enforce the zoning.
Well, then maybe what we should do is just have Jim go notify him, and then he'll have to come in before the board or something like that.
Well, first thing we need to do is look at the zoning bylaw and make sure we have some sort of footing to tell.
Right.
I mean, if I don't, they're not in front of me, but if the zoning bylaw says you can't have those flag looking things, and it clearly says you can't have them, well then we just have to tell Jim, shut them down. And if the zoning bylaw has a temporary signage section that says you can't have temporary signs on the side of a 40-foot trailer, then we can shut them down.
Maybe we can get one of the members of the Board of Selectmen down here to talk about the parking, the parking situation down there, because they're the ones that are gonna deal with it. Let me see if Jack is up there.
Giorgio's crossing the street. I mean, it's a highway.
It's a dangerous
major highway, but it's a highway.
You know, when I first came on the board, Heidi gave me the zoning bylaws to read. And I kept saying, I don't know if you want me to read all these zoning bylaws. She said, why? It's because we're not enforcing half the bylaws we have.
I run upstairs, but I'll check them instead.
Wouldn't it be a good idea just to call Larry Spellman in and talk to him once?
I think we should have him in before his next auction.
That's
May 2nd. Is it May
2nd?
I thought it was May 24th.
No, it's May.
It's May.
It's the first weekend of May.
Gentlemen, under 33...
Oh, you found it?
3322, no pennant streamers, advertising flag spinners, and similar devices shall be permitted.
So there you go. Those are flags, as clear as...
Moving animated, revolving moving light, or flashing sign, or sign element shall be permitted, except for this.
We didn't get you on camera. You can do it. Do it one more time.
That's okay.
My vote would be to call Larry Spellman in and talk to him about that before we go and pull something that...
Yeah, that makes sense. It's a courtesy to him.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, hey, check your bylaws.
But we need to find out what his next option is.
Can go in there, and he's not there all the time.
No, he's not.
He lives in New Hampshire, doesn't he?
Yeah.
There's a lot of property that they own. I don't know why he can't provide parking for everybody over there.
I think what he was saying makes a lot of sense. It's probably a mud pit back there. And any of those vehicles get on there, they're gonna sink out of sight.
Yeah, nobody can have people parking on
there. They're all
I understand, and that's the reason why we have to give them
I think, a courtesy.
Oh, absolutely, agreed 100%.
Couldn't the police do warnings on the vehicles that are parked on 38 residential?
They should.
They just saw it, ticket them.
It won't do a warning like they do for people.
If they had a detail on the street as well as within the property, then that detail could be the eyes of, you know, keep things straight, but.
We could have our department put up temporary no parking signs along 138 right there.
Yeah.
In Somerset Avenue.
Just like when they have, when we have the.
The cow chip.
The cow chip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a Rujo's sign.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe that's the answer. Cause the, Mr. Sullivan can't police it, but those orange signs certainly.
And then if people violate it, then there's a good reason.
Good reason to take it.
Yeah. So.
But before we go and shut them down, because that really will be.
No, we would shut them down, we just have a conversation.
We'll shut them down, I think we should just give them a call or, you know, I can call him, I have his number.
If you know him, go ahead and talk to him.
I definitely.
Informally probably the best bet.
Yeah, informal is definitely the best bet, just talk to him and say, we've raised some concerns and what do you have to say about it?
Before it gets blown out of proportion.
Yeah, exactly, cause it's early, he's only been there for 8 months now? This is probably his fourth or fifth?
I think he's had at least three.
He had one in November, January.
January.
March, May, so this is his fourth.
Hey, Brett.
This is Brett.
Okay, so you gotta call him and try.
So, any more public input?
Actually, there's one more thing that comes up as far as that property. In between Daddy-O's and the liquor store, there's a road. Is that a road or is it a driveway?
I think it's a driveway.
It's not very wide.
Because what I'm thinking of.
It's not a recognized road.
We don't know that.
Oh, no?
No, because I've seen that on the GPS as Mockingbird Road or.
Really?
There is a road through the backside of the property that comes out on Elm. It's a dirt road over there. I just don't know if that's ever been an accepted road. What I'm thinking of is the town is talking about buying that building.
Hey, never mind. Yeah, it's me.
Where's the frontage to that?
Never mind, I'll talk to you later.
Right, so what's the purpose of, how can we buy something that's.
Cause we have no frontage.
I'm in a meeting right now.
Because the ZBA would give a variance.
But my point is the value of that property.
Is not 1.4 million or whatever it was they wanted.
Why, you won't buy it?
If we were to do an appraisal of it as is, I guess it's kinda grandfathered in as a truck shed, whatever you wanna call it.
My point is, from a business standpoint.
Yeah.
If we buy something that doesn't meet the zoning, does that make sense?
Well, that's why we kinda tabled the whole thing. As far as
Now, if that's a road.
It's not a road, it's a driveway. It's definitely not a road.
Yeah, 100% sure.
100% sure. We discussed it at that meeting, that interdepartmental meeting, and it was not a road and it's still not a road.
You were there?
I was there, I don't remember the.
Yeah, it was definitely.
Talking about that.
No, we talked about the lack of frontage and how it was, had limited marketability based on the lack of frontage and that it's kinda grandfathered in, but it's not worth 1.4 million because it's limited as to what you can do with it.
My question is, if you go a Mockingbird Road on the GPS,
And it shows that there, what does that mean?
Mockingbird is in one of the subdivisions, it's not there.
Is it Mockingbird?
Mockingbird Lane is off of Elm.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yes, I think it's a continuance.
So you think that might be a paper road?
It can't be, Mockingbird Lane's a new subdivision. That's only been there probably like 5-6 years.
But a paper road could have been there for 200 years.
Yeah.
But.
Locate Mockingbird Road.
There is a road.
Mockingbird Lane is the subdivision.
There is a road that went from Mendoza Farm in that area.
Yeah.
Right down through, there was a sawmill in the middle somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
And went all the way down to the Packers store.
Jesus.
Wow. I remember the Puerto Ricans on the farm when I was working on the farm 100 years ago. Rainy day, they'd go down, they were working.
Yeah.
They were gonna buy about 40 gallons of wine. Come back.
Locating Mockingbird Road, this may not be completely accurate, but here it is.
What are we gonna do with Maris Lane now? I don't think Craig wants that pipe above ground, man, I think that's where it's gonna end up.
That'd be an eyesore, major eyesore.
That pipe's gonna stop right there, right where we see it now, today?
They have to create a, like a.
Head wall.
Catch basin.
Head wall, catch basin, something like that, it's gonna.
Oh, you think they're gonna put a catch basin right there?
So that's gonna stop right there.
Yeah, that's the dead end.
And that lake goes right into that other fellow's yard.
So the water's still gonna go on his property?
Right, because Jessica's house is here, and the pipe goes behind it here, right?
Yeah.
And then that other fellow's house is here, the first house.
Yeah.
And that's where all the water is here that goes right into his garage.
So now there's gonna be more water.
Comes out here, so it's all gonna be directed his way.
No, it's supposed to be.
Pipe rated to back the other way.
Yeah, it's supposed to go the other way.
Yeah, but after it comes out of the pipe, this man's house is.
No, it's not coming out of the pipe, it's going into the pipe.
Oh, that's gonna go in the pipe.
Supposed to go in the pipe.
That's the plan.
That's gonna be.
I don't know about that.
The pipe seems to be sitting up high. Oh. It's supposed to work the other way.
Oh, I thought it was draining down in.
That's what I thought. What do I know?
God. No, it's supposed to go from the head wall.
I can say.
Into the.
What day did it rain like crazy?
Yesterday, no.
Not day before.
Okay, so I drove through there yesterday and there was not a lot of standing water.
You think it's gonna work?
Yeah, okay.
So.
No, I don't.
And I expected to see a flooded yard.
Yeah.
I think the water, if the water gets to the pipe, it'll go. But the problem is, there is a lot higher spot.
His property's not graded properly to go to the pipe.
Correct, that's the issue.
So his property's gonna be graded uphill. So my question would be, how does the water?
What happened, the day, when he had that, all that water standing over there, I actually walked on there. And I measured it down, and right at the end, at the bottom of his driveway, he had about 8 inches of water. And I walked straight across to where the pipe is at now, and it went to 4. So that means that before the water drains into that area, I mean, once the water drains down 4 inches, he'll still have 4 inches of water standing at the bottom of his driveway, which probably take half of his backyard. So, and then I'm looking at the pipe, and I without a laser, I couldn't tell, but the bottom of that pipe and his driveway, the bottom of his driveway, there's not gonna be that big of a difference there.
I don't think so either.
So therefore, that pipe is there. Yeah, once his yard fills up, then the pipe will take over. You know, the water will go into the pipe. That's
not how it's designed.
No.
No, but honestly, I think that pipe should have been placed lower.
Yeah.
From what I remember seeing, and I don't know where the plans are. I mean, if we could look.
Did
over
they
the,
even use a transit over there?
Oh, I'm sure they did. I'm sure they did. And Peter was supposed to have been there.
Yeah.
And check. And
well, there was a fellow that went. What's his name?
I forget his name.
Is it Matt?
Hey, we'll wait and
GZA,
see.
Yeah, there's a guy who works for GZA. His name
his name is Matt.
Yeah,
name.
Matt.
Okay.
I forget
his
last name, but his name's Matt as well.
I just don't know if
that was, if they called them every time they did work over there.
You've been out there twice and I know, right?
Yeah. At least twice.
He's witnessed where they stopped, and he said it's not finished, so we'll see.
It's not finished?
Not, no, it's not finished.
Needs a head wall and some grading.
According to the guy that was there, last there working with the excavator, he said he's all done.
Yeah, the big excavator's gone.
Right. Now, Matt may be going back there to do some more work.
Maybe some final grading and.
Matt Antonio's, so I really don't know.
I hope it works.
Yeah, well, until the engineers bless it or curse it, we really, there's not much work for us to do.
Exactly.
But I do know that I don't feel comfortable with that at all.
Any motions?
What else we wanna talk about?
We covered it all.
Got everything.
We, far as I know, don't have a PDF from the Strawberry Fields folks yet.
It could be in there.
Yeah.
But I can't get to it. I can't get Outlook to open, 'cause there's a message that they sent us one, do we want hard copies? So you wanna call tomorrow and say?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I got the message.
We probably need hard copies to distribute, I mean, I'd rather not have them, but the fire chief is gonna wanna get a hard copy and maybe the Todd Pilling, maybe not, but.
Todd Pilling?
He's the, Board of Health.
I'll have to call the other guy while you call him. Remember Jeff Hickey from our last meeting?
No.
That didn't show up?
Who's that?
I think he has.
Jeff Hickey, what do you want?
I think he has the plan up there off of,
Landscaping Jeff Hickey?
Off of North Street. He bought some property up there, it was an old, it's an old subdivision.
Oh.
He was on the agenda last time. Wanted to just informally discuss it, what his options are. And if it meets all the requirements, then he should be able to just go ahead and do it.
This is the Form A?
I don't know what he has, to be honest with you.
This is.
But he wanted to come in tonight, but I just got the message tonight.
Is it the middle school? He was at the middle school?
No, he called, left a message on the phone.
So he wasn't at the last meeting?
No, 'cause he didn't show up.
Oh, okay, I don't. I'll call.
Yeah, you look all suit he wants, I don't know.
Mary Jacobs Driscoll tomorrow and I'll call.
No, no, it's Mary Jacobs Driscoll.
Oh, Mary Jacobs Driscoll.
Mary. Yeah. And, it's probably in there, but I can't get Outlook to open for some silly reason.
That's fine.
And, it's 11x17, that'd be good, huh? For review purposes.
Depends, you know.
I can't imagine what they did, but.
I don't know. I'll, I'm gonna ask her to email me a copy and then I'll decide, it's the easiest. Email me a copy and give us some hard copies. Or maybe if she can email me hard PDF in the morning and if it's chock-a-block full of information with a very small print, which you can zoom in on a screen, but you can't zoom in that easily, so 11x17 might not be the best, or maybe we need some of both.
Yeah.
I don't know if she's giving us just a site plan or 37 pages, so.
No, I hope it's not, yeah.
She'd still have to.
They already spent like $100,000 on that project, so.
Crazy people, you still have to make a determination on the reasonableness of whether 45 lots is reasonable, so.
Well, maybe they cut some out.
Yeah, we'll find out. Yeah, I'll have her email me a PDF.
If you do get one, could you?
I'll distribute it, whatever I get, I will distribute it, 'cause.
Thank you.
No one wants to have to come in here to look at a piece of paper, I would imagine.
Not really.
Although, if all you're doing is looking at it on your phone.
Yeah.
That's pretty tough to see. You got a computer, you just don't use it.
I do, I just don't use it.
Yeah.
But.
Tablet.
No, it's mainly to hand it out to the right people.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Jerry, do the letter for you to sign to the Board of Selectmen for associates.
No, she didn't.
You forget about it.
She did not. We'll remind her on Monday when she gets back.
Yeah. Okay. Motion to adjourn, maybe?
That would be good.
Second.
On favor?
Aye.
Good night, Cable.